pre-counting activities of electronically transmitted postal ballot paper. Disclaimer: this training material is for use in training of election officials. It should not be referred as guideline of ECI. In case of any variation in this training material, the commission guideline, rules, laws shall prevail. Learning outcomes. At the end of the session, the participants will be able to explain the pre-counting activities for EPB counting, understand the process of scanning and valid marking of e-postal ballot. They will also be able to cite the steps to be followed if any of the form 13A, 13B or 13C is missing. In e-postal ballot counting, scanning of form 13A, 13B and 13C is done as pre-counting activity. Besides scanning, procedure for counting of votes for electronic transmitted postal ballot is the same as in the case of other postal ballots. Pre-counting activities. First, the returning officer have to log in on ETPBS portal. After login, the dashboard shown on the screen will be displayed. Now, the returning officer have to click on the pre-counting button. So now the returning officer will select the pre-counting button. He will set up scanning devices and he will be ready for scanning the e-postal ballot. Now this page will be displayed on the portal. Sequence to be followed. The sequence for scanning the forms will be: first the form 13C will be scanned, then form 13A and at last form 13B. Sequence of QR code scanning will not be changed under any circumstances. First we have to scan the form 13C, then form 13A and then form 13B. Process of scanning and valid marking of e-postal ballot in ideal condition. First, we will scan the QR code of outer envelope, that is form 13C. Now we will open the form 13C and take out form 13A and form 13B. So after scanning the QR code of form 13C, we will open it and we will find two things, form 13A and form 13B. Now we will scan the first QR code of form 13A followed by the scanning of the second QR code. After then, the QR code of form 13B will be scanned. After successful scanning of all the forms, we will mark the system generated serial number with pencil on form 13A, 13B and 13C. Then we will put the form 13B and 13A back inside the form 13C and will place it in the basket, which will be for valid EPB. Process of scanning and valid marking of EPB if form 13C is not getting scanned. We are unable to scan the form 13C. So now we will open the form 13C and take out form 13A and 13B. Search the elector by the name in the tab of form 13C. So we are unable to scan the QR code of form 13C. Now we will search the elector by name in the tab of form 13C. Once found the elector, we will click on the add button to proceed. Now we will scan the first QR code of 13A followed by the scanning of the second QR code of form 13A. Now we will scan the QR code of form 13B. Mark the system generated serial number with pencil on form 13A, 13B and 13C. Then put the form 13B and 13A back inside the form 13C. Place the form 13C in the basket of valid or rejected EPB as the case may be. Process of scanning and valid marking of EPB if form 13A is not getting scanned. Scan the QR code of outer envelope, that is form 13C. Open the envelope and take out form 13A and form 13B. So after scanning the QR code of form 13C, we have to open it and we should find two things, form 13A and form 13B. If anyone of the QR code is not getting scanned, then manually enter the 40-digit alphanumeric EPB into the system. So now start manual entry of EPB ID and add the elector of Form 13A. Once the EPB ID entered, click on the Add button to proceed. If Form 13A is not getting scanned, then we have to manually enter the 40-digit alphanumeric number and then we will click on the Add button. After entering the 40-digit alphanumeric number, scan the QR code of Form 13B. Mark the system generated serial number with pencil on Form 13A, 13B and 13C. Then put the Form 13B and 13A back inside the Form 13C. Place the Form 13C in the basket of valid or rejected EPB as the case may be. Process of scanning and valid marking of EPB if Form 13B is not getting scanned. Scan the QR code of outer envelope Form 13C. Open the envelope and take out Form 13A and Form 13B. We will scan the QR code of Form 13C, open it and take out the Form 13A and Form 13B. Scan the first QR code of Form 13A followed by the scanning of the second QR code. Now we are unable to scan the QR code of Form 13B. Start manual entry of EPB ID and add the elector for Form 13B marking. Once the EPB ID entered, click on the Add button to proceed. So if Form 13B is not getting scanned, then manually we have to enter the 40-digit alphanumeric number, then click on the Add button for adding the Form 13B. Mark system generated serial number with pencil on the back side of Form 13A, 13B and 13C, then put the Form 13B and 13A back inside the outer envelope Form 13C. Place the Form 13C in the basket of valid or rejected EPB as the case may be. Process of scanning and valid marking of EPB if Form 13A is missing. Scan the QR code of outer envelope, that is Form 13C. After scanning the QR code of Form 13C, we will open it and ideally we should find two things, Form 13A and Form 13B. But Form 13A is missing. Form 13A is not found inside the Form 13C. So now we will mark the Form 13A missing from the drop-down menu and reject the e-postal ballot. Put the Form 13B envelope back inside the Form 13C. Place the Form 13C in the basket of rejected EPB. Process of scanning and valid marking of EPB if Form 13B is missing. Scan the QR code of outer envelope Form 13C. After scanning the QR code of Form 13C, we will open it and ideally we should find two things. Form 13A, that is declaration of the elector, and a smaller envelope, that is Form 13B. But the Form 13B is missing. Now we will scan the first QR code of Form 13A followed by the scanning of the second QR code of Form 13A. Now we will mark the Form 13B missing from the drop down menu and reject the EPB. Put Form 13A back inside the outer envelope Form 13C. Place the Form 13C in the basket of rejected EPB. Process of scanning and valid marking of EPB if Form 13C is duplicate. The outer cover Form 13C, which is having QR code on lower right hand side, has to be scanned by the QR code reader and necessary valid checks will be performed for possible duplicates and verification of the service elector. A unique serial number will be provided by the system. This serial number has to be manually marked by the returning officer on the envelope Form 13C. So we will scan the QR code of Form 13C and if we found the Form 13C is duplicate, then if the system marks a duplicate, then it will indicate the serial number with which it is duplicate. In this case, all the EPB marked as duplicate has to be tied together and kept in the invalid tray. In this educational video, we have learned about the pre-counting activities of e-postal ballot paper. If you have any doubt or want any clarification, then you can contact through the mail as shown on the screen. For other videos and rules and regulations, you can visit the web address as shown. Thank you.